What happened here? When you look at it, you see he's trying to take the turn. And it looks like this is lower. So when he makes the turn, he pulls, and then the whole thing tips over, and this is the end result. And when you look at it, he enters the turn, and he takes the turn a little bit too narrow. Here's a low spot. When you look carefully, you see how is this trailer suspension placed? Can you look at it? What do you think? What kind of a suspension system is used here?
Four points.
Why 4 points? Careful look.
I think it's 3 points.
3 points.
Yeah. Because
because
the axles in the front, yeah, have the
they're equal,
yeah.
So this is 1 point, that's 1 point. So what about this?
So this is 1 point that
together.
Yeah.
It tipped over, so these axles went out and these went in.
Yeah.
So the rear is 1 point. You can see. And you have 2 points here. And apparently symmetrical points. So can you imagine, here is your center of gravity of the load, and then he's pulling this way, and when he and then you have 1, 2, 3. Now there is an argument going on, should we have the first, the 1 point in the front or in the back? It was here in the back. To my opinion, it should be in the front. But again, nobody knows. One says front, other one says back. Let's agree on something. Why it should be in the front, to my opinion, is this. Here we have a lower area. If the trailer enters the corner and goes into this lower area, if this was 1 point, you would see the tires on this side go down. And the whole trailer will go down, but it will not tilt. It will only go down in the front a little bit too much. And the operator, which had to should walk here, should be alarmed and sees the trailer going down, not tilt, but going down. These axles extend. So he knows if I have my second 2 points entering in this curve, I have to raise this one to stay level and use the spirit level and check it.
Raise lower.
Huh?
Lower.
Race.
The front goes down.
The front goes down. This equalizes. This is 1 point.
Yeah.
So it equalizes. The whole trailer goes a little bit down because here we go down with the tires, and the hydraulics make sure that these axles are equalized. But as soon as this one goes also in this dip, he wants to go down as well, and then he will tip. So he should raise this point to keep it level. Yeah?
From the trailer in the picture that they have never went down.
Yeah, and then what also does not help, by pulling with the tractor here, he's also pulling on the side, remember? Pulling this way is this way, force that way. Remember the parallelogram? So you have also a side force, which also helps to make it tip over.
But if you have a trailer operator in the back, how we operate it, huh?
Yeah.
We have a power pack in the back.
Yeah.
And the operator is sitting on the power pack.
Yeah.
And his eyes on the level, on the water level.
Yeah.
And when he ever sees the bubble go to one direction,
he has to raise the right point.
We do it the way either he raises
or lowers. Correct.
The same point. So there's no messing up points, huh?
Yeah.
So if they go around the turn, even in the same configuration, he sees that the water level goes down, then he pushes it up, and I think nothing would have happened.
No, correct, if he had done that. But apparently they have not done that yet.
No.
They just went in, and they didn't pay attention.
No.
And that's how most of the accidents happen, human error. They do not pay attention, they have not been told why and how, etc., etc. So the message here is, instruct your operational personnel to do the right thing. and make understand why it should be done like that. Yeah? What happened? I don't know. I got these pictures last year. They sent them to me by mail. By the way, in case you come across any accidents or any pictures, projects who are interested, please mail them to me. I'll put them on my website. I have a section of interesting projects, and I have some sections on my website which are all dealing with accidents. Funny accidents, serious accidents, bad accidents. The main purpose is to learn from accidents so that we don't make the same mistakes again and again. I think, I don't know the reason, but my honest opinion is this was not leveled. It could also be maybe a mechanical or hydraulic failure, but that's very rare. Yeah?